Hello and welcome. What's going on, people? Welcome to a very special episode of Artisan Circuit Review. Today is MLK Day, and there's a lot going on.
True to what you said on paper. If I lived in China or even Russia or any totalitarian country, maybe I could understand some of these illegal injunctions. Maybe I could understand the denial of certain basic First Amendment privileges because they haven't committed themselves to that over there. But somewhere I read of the freedom of assembly. Somewhere I read of the freedom of speech. Somewhere I read of the freedom of press. Somewhere I read that the greatness of America is the right to protest far right. Say we aren't going to let any dogs or water hoses turn us around. We aren't going to let any injunction turn us around. Well, I don't know what will happen now. We've got some difficult days ahead. But it really doesn't matter with me now because I've been to the mountaintop. Like anybody, I would like to live a long life. Longevity has its place. But I'm not concerned about that now. I just want to do God's will. And He's allowed me to go up to the mountain. And I've looked over. And I've seen the promised land. I may not get there with you, but I want you to know tonight that we as a people will get to the promised land. So I'm happy tonight. I'm not worried about anything. I'm not fearing any man. Mine eyes have seen the glory of the coming of the Lord.
Hello. What's going on, people? So, today is a very emotional day. Not the over-emotional fake kind or forced kind or assumed kind. Well, anyway, I'm very happy to be in this energy of about what I'm about to talk about. And, you know, excuse the placement of slots on Awareness Careless Broadcasting Network. Because why? Because the type of artisan that someone that speaks publicly and is spiritual is different from the other artists. The more popular artist is something fast feeling, something quick to see, something like, whoa, right? And that's a musician and a person who draws or paints, whatever, you know what I'm trying to say. But these are all artisans. Spiritual people are part of the artisan planet. That's what it is. This planet, Earth. And so a lot of people might think, oh, this is pretty heavy. Like right now, I'm not playing any music because I was playing Dr. King, but I usually play a little music now. I'm actually looking for something right now. You guys might be a little shocked, but I have revisited a lot of emotional things in my life in the span of 2 hours, which is really weird because it, you know, so much in such short time, you know what I mean? So, what I'm trying to do is I'm trying to find some, gospel. But, forgive the, you know, taking long. It's just, it's been a really difficult morning. Not in a negative sense, like, oh God, you know, but it has, like, thinking wise. And feeling energy, vortex of energy, Dr. Martin Luther King, and the truth, okay? I would usually be, like, trolling, you know, things that are not exactly false in religion, but not really explained correctly, or viewed out of context, you know, because this day and age, I really do respect religion, not the part of it that, you know, obviously it's really bad, you know, for society, but the part of it that is good for society, because the good parts of it, like, obviously people live unto themselves the best they could to this, about, you know, loving your family and stuff like that, right? But there's also a lot of artists out there that were so traumatized to fractal state, or however they say it, that they, you know, don't look at, they don't understand family. They don't know what it's like to have the feeling of support, so they wouldn't ever think to push their love probably to anyone. You know, but these are a lot of artists are like this. So this proves maybe, you know, artists are targeted, you know. Anyway, still having this slowness. sorry, people. It's been a tough morning. So it took me finally. You know what I was listening to? Juanita Bynum. Big shout out to Juanita Bynum. I love you, sister. When I was young, I thought she was like, I think I was like, maybe in my 20s. And I think in my 20s, I was a Christian at the time. Well, anyway, I'm going to play this. Take a quick break. All right, this is pretty cool. I know we were listening to Dr. King, but this actually is something. Hold on 1 second. I am not afraid to go past the time on this because I'm going to save this special moment and have to wait to maybe I'll upload this on the Chris Black Los Angeles if it doesn't work on ACBN. Here we go, here we go.
But one thing I do know is that I came tonight because I need you. And you need me. Because we're all a part of God's army. And how many know this tonight? I believe this, that it is the will of God that every need that you have, it be supplied. Oh, how many of y'all feel that? Turn around and touch 3 people around you. Don't be scared. Because they may be looking like they don't want to have church, but they playing. Tell them I need you. I need you. You need me. Don't be acting funny. Because I may be your next miracle. Your breakthrough may be in me. You might be sitting next to your divine connection. Don't act like you don't want to talk to me now. Woo! Dr. Canyon? Oh, somebody just lift your hands up. Just lift your hands up. Ah, God comes up. Jesus. just feel his love in this place tonight. Thank you, Jesus. You need me. We're all a part of God's body. Stand with me. Can I get somebody to agree with me? We're all a part of God's body. It is his will. Not some of your needs. Every last one of you. And they're going to be. Oh, you important to the Lord. Wow. You, I wouldn't have a ministry. You're the reason why I came. My God. Thank you, Jesus.
We're back.
Have you ever wondered what would happen if you actually sat down and talked with missionaries from the church?
Well, you know, you guys know me.
Okay.
I am not a religion type person. However, I retract the things of old that belong to where it's supposed to belong to and say, this is where this comes from. not this plagiarized thing. Not trying to disrespect, I'm just saying the facts. But however, the people, the church, mosque, temple, whatever, the people, adore them. Adore them in a sense that when you say somebody who you admire, no, it's not about admiration. It's about when you feel others and how everybody is going through the same thing. And there's so many people that are not strong like others in the sense of freedom, free mind. Okay? And I was one of those people. Okay? My God, I had no idea. I put all my trust and all my energy and all my thing into this archonic ideal. Again, no disrespect. Why am I doing this? Because, like I said, it's a truth. Not many people would come on the radio and talk their personal life only because, some people just want to, jack around.
I say that to be funny, and it is kind of trolling, but I say this because I remember being in church, and I remember the people who I met, and I love them. And you don't be a part of something, especially being a person that, you're pretty in tune, emotional intelligence is what I'm talking about, okay? There's a lot of people that, it's not that they're not emotionally intelligent, they're just absolutely rejected and they abhor it. That's fine. You've got to deal with it. Or you don't deal with it. But I deal with it. I deal with so many people that you would care about, you think they're, cold, but they're so cold. They're so cold towards you. A lot of people. You know what I mean? And that's the way it is. You don't know why. See? That's the truth right there. But it doesn't matter. Because what is this show about? I'm sorry. I'm getting so heavy. And so today, the truth about today, okay? Why do they remember somebody? Something great and something very bad. And the truth is, I am not trying to bring a gloom, because we don't need that. Believe me, the earth doesn't need that. What I'm pointing at is today I want to point out my frustration against the Archon. Okay? And mostly to lift up the gods of the earth, who I absolutely adore in every way. Okay? I've never been so passionate about anything in my life because of the truth of who the gods are, where did they come from, okay, and about this planet. Whether the truth was that this was the home of the gods, or, this was the home of animals, or, the gods came and settled. It doesn't matter. What matters is that we all, I don't care who you think you are, where you think you come from, or what you think is the truth. But it's certainly not the term minority. I don't care what people are counting. Okay? But today is a very special day. In honor of not just Martin Luther King, but the entire melanated planet of old, and the spirits of old, and the people today, and everything. Because it's not about Martin Luther King, really. It's really not. You know why? He's just because
in a time where people were absolutely death-defyingly terrified. You know why death-defyingly terrified is a term for me or a phrase? Because you're fucking with your life, not fighting for it to the death. Because when you fight for your right, your soul, right air to fucking breathe in this motherfucking planet, and you do it like a man or like a powerful woman, and you fucking do it, then you do it. And nobody will, I'm not going to say nobody will come against you, but nobody's going to beat you. Okay, I don't care what they make things seem to be. But the gods are not losing. We're never losing. The gods are never, we're never losing. It's always winning, because the only thing that you see here on this planet with these mofo archons is the absolute cheat hate machine. Okay? Where they have divided everyone against the gods. But what is this? Revolutionary version of Artisan Circuit Review? Yeah, that's right. You know what? Again, I say it again. Artisan are also have spiritual folks. People that speak. It's a talent. It's a gift. It's a power. It's an ability, or it's a heart thing. It's a soul thing. You know? So, and this is what I'm talking about. So lately, you know, I've been thinking about the things of religion, like, why do they say? We also say, is it this or that? And we, if it's not right, we completely go against it. But there's a truth behind things, you know what I mean? It's not about hating the Archon or constantly being like, F them. You don't have to do that. We live. We lift. We live. We lift. We live and we lift. You know? You get strong like that. But we gotta take care of ourselves. People, I gotta tell you, there's a thing out there about sleeplessness. There is this idea how resetting our body some way and not contorting the energy, but doing something that causes it to trip up with being sleepless, also in a time in our lives, gain some type of energy through some type of portal, maybe, or something that happens to our quantum body. And then we become it in our regular selves. We become it. You know, instead of talking about the deity and saying, oh, this deity, okay? You just be it and walk it. You know what I mean? But you do it with valor. As if you are the ultimate of it. That's the ultimate manifestation. Manifesting things are not, ooh, big deal. So what? Okay, if you manifested a mansion, you could lose it just like that. I'm telling you. It's manifesting yourself to become. That's the idea of becoming, and that you manifest in the first place. Because people kind of do it backwards because they don't believe who they are. Because of where they are and what's happening and what society is, have some kind of strange kaleidoscope, but that center that they're showing is the you that they attacked and they made messed up. And they say, oh, this is what he, this is what she is, this is what he is. See? Sometimes, maybe you need a little release, or maybe you need a little, you know, something. But I know that every time I do try to do these things, I also just become disgusted with
what was in the past, you know, because I always wondered, oh, why is, how come no matter what, and nobody could understand, you know, people begin to blame and say, look at what you do, look at how you are, look at this, but nobody understands what the system is, you know, causing electronically, electric current waves, however it is, however it's being dispensed, it doesn't matter, okay? Very happy right now because I decided not to get all crazy about the 15 minutes for the ACBN, the Awareness Careless Broadcasting Network. Why? Because that's who it is. That's who we are. It's not a bad feeling. You'd have to lie and say that it's a bad feeling to think of love in a perfection way of this being or this collective or this thing that you look at like it's a parent, but you can't see them because it's cosmic. See, and that's the thing. Is it because they explain science and people get turned away because they get not bored but maybe discouraged that they are afraid that it's going to take so long to learn what you're trying to tell them that they give up and they say, all right, forget it. And that's why they didn't tell people that the religion is not this thing like that, like a parent. It's a happening that you go through in phases and changes because of the shifting of planets and stars and the sun, which where we live in, that nobody can say, oh, no, the religion is like this. See, this is why. Hey? But this is not about attacking religion. This is not about attacking Christians or attacking these people who might, I've been playing their music that they're going to, or I've said about wanting to buy it, they look at me and go, oh, he's against God. Oh, this guy was sent to bring us down. That, there you go. That's where you lose the blessing. I'm not trying to be like, oh, you better call me on my phone and be my friend. No, it's because I'm telling the truth about things. You know? We want to believe so badly inside us because of the falsified information that we attain through families. Not because something's wrong with the families or something's wrong with each human. No, it's because of whatever happened a long time ago. And the shifting with information and lies, you know, for purpose. Okay? So, and this is why I say this is a very special episode. Okay? You're not going to hear me talk heavy like this because why? Because artisan sometimes are, most of the time, is about, maybe sometimes I pick somebody specific. I apologize for the day that, I think it was probably episode 3 where I played Cab Calloway and I didn't talk about him. But today I can say, Cab Calloway, you know, in this world, you're not going to have a man or a woman, right? If they're known to be great, if we think about it, the known is controlled, right? How, and Cab Calloway is like 1937 or something. Sorry if I'm wrong about the exact, but that's a real long time ago, okay? And Cab Calloway is an amazing black man. Amazing melanated man who is multi-talented, okay? This is one of the gods of the earth, because we all know the famous, you know, Minnie the Moocher, but nobody really thinks, probably, or nobody, doesn't really talk about it too much because it was a long time ago, old artist, right? But I have to say, you know, I thought it was kind of funny because I had cooked something, you know, that I wasn't used to cooking, and it came out really amazing. And I was searching for songs that, you know, we only think of songs in a way that we're entertained by on a level of just listening to the song. But these days, you kind of try to, there's people matching songs to their video. And when I say video, I mean your little snippets on, like, you know, Instagram or TikTok, you know. Not making a movie, right? So I was looking for a thing for food, right? And I can't believe that there's a song that Cab Calloway sung about cooking. You know, one of the parts of the song where he says, everybody eats when they come to my house. And then I think he changes the lyrics around maybe the second verse or somebody goes, you better eat it. And I died. Because you know a lot about a person when you hear certain things. When it comes to frequency and vibration, sound, you know, and being intuitive, you know why people say the things they say, okay? And it was a happy moment when a man hears about, you know, being a man. Forgive the sound interruption, but I'm, you know, a little boxed in here. Anyway, so, anyway, I realized, you know, Cab Calloway, that's a man's man. That dude, is strong and, like, he didn't take no shit from nobody. That's what I mean. And you could tell that just by him saying, you better eat it. And this song, that shit was funny as hell, I swear to God. But I'm just, today is a day that I am, sometimes you get the blessing of really seeing something you pray for, and I see it. You know, it's like, my God. And you say, why? Why? Why would somebody make such a big deal about this? They don't understand the logic, the real true logic. You know, they say to ignore something you don't like. It's very true. But the atrocity, and I should say the highest atrocity. I know, oh, it's so dramatic. Yeah, the highest atrocity against humanity of all was the past. People think that indigenous is the ancient times. No, it's not. Indigenous is new. Why? Because indigenous is the result of an atrocity happening to a planet of gods. Is that some kind of truth? Like, wait a minute. We looked at these kind of weird, messed up planets that don't look like nothing but maybe not fully formed. There you go. Maybe not fully formed, or maybe that's what happens when a planet, but when a planet gets destroyed, the whole thing goes kaputsky, and then you don't see it, and the sediments, you know, break apart and fall apart, and starts burning, you know? Anyway, we see these planets today. They are what they are, right? We know that we receive energy, and that it comes from a gaseous form, a gaseous state, gas. Right? If you get too much of it, you get nerve damage. But if you get just the right amount, something connects magnetically with our immediate magnetic currents flowing in a vortex of this, our own perimeter, you know, your own self. Like energy, the way your energy, you think you're just you, what you see, your head, your shoulders, your hands, your feet, your body. No, part of you that's alive and can get hurt, you got to be careful, you got to know who you are, is also your magnetic field. So what is that? So what am I saying? The obvious, the absolute of it, like something that's regular, natural, would be if something happens, and something happens in the energy of the air of where you reside. Or maybe, yeah, I would probably say reside, or maybe be around, whatever. And your magnetic flow of what's part of your body, because they say, if you have your hand, or you have your face, or any part of your body, and something swings and barely, right? But it's like, come so close, you don't feel nothing. But guess what? You don't realize that's also your energy. And the reason why you're like, whoa, it's not because of fear. Yeah, that's a result, but it's because of the energy of it, whatever's behind it. Something we don't know, but the person. So you know that we as beings, no matter how we're mixed with the Archon, because that is the truth, we'd have to accept that what is happening to us, what's the result of things, which the society and the Archon made you think that things are happening, and you kind of look back at symptoms or reactions or cause and effect. But you realize that it's very small compared to where it's coming from, okay? So it's not your fault. A lot of things are not your fault. The way if things happen, why does this happen? No, it's not you. It's not. It's not only planets, because it's got some power there, but it's when something is redirecting that energy and causing you to think that it's natural or that it's your fault, when in fact it's not. And how has that advanced? It's become technology, and they use it against us. Okay? So, here we go. Some more music. And where are we? We are at 37 minutes. I love it. So because we already passed even the normal half hour of a segment, the episode is going into, obviously, a longer show, obviously. So here we go with another break. Be right back.
I can't say what's left to do. Come on. Truth is, I'm weak. No strength to fight. No tears to cry. Even if I try, but still my soul refuses to die. Mm-hmm. One touch will change my life. Take me to the King. I don't have much to breathe. My heart. Chasing after you. don't have much to bring. My heart's torn to pieces. It's my offering.
Why don't you own commercial real estate? Yes, you. Why don't you own?
He saw the best in me. When everyone else around me could only see the worst in me. I wish I had a witness tonight. Said he saw the best in me. I guess I'm the only one that got this testimony. When everyone else around me can only see the worst in me. Can I tell y'all one more time, one more time? I said he saw the best in me. When everyone else around me could only see the worst in me. I wish I had a witness tonight. All I need is one. Hey!
He saw the best in me.
When everyone else around me, yeah. Anybody have that testimony? When fuck walked you off, said you would never make it, what did he see?
He saw the best in me.
When everyone else around me asked, oh.
When everyone else around me could only see the worst in me.
Can I tell y'all one more thing? I just need to tell you one more thing. Listen to this. See, he's mine. And I am his. It doesn't matter what I did. He only sees me for who I am. Does anybody know that tonight? Oh, see, he is mine. And I am his. Said it doesn't matter what I did. See, he only sees me for who I am.
Tonight.
That makes
may be somebody else's testimony. Help me say it, help me say it.
He saw the best in me.
Everyone else around me. Can I ask y'all one question? The question is simply this. What did he see?
He saw the best.
I can't get no help up in here. Because there are some folk in here that people have wrote you off. Said you would never amount to anything. Said that you would never end up being anywhere. But Myron, tell him one more time. What did he see?
He saw the best.
When mama said you would never be nothing. When aunties and uncles said that you'd never amount to anything. When daddy didn't come home anymore. He didn't look at you and say that you weren't going to make it. God looked at you and what did he see? What did he see?
He saw the best.
Yeah, is there anybody here tonight that's so very thankful that God did not write you off? That he did not throw you away? That he picked you up?
And we're back. ACBN. ACBN. We're back. ACBN. How do you say that? I don't want to make the joke of the WNBC, but that's funny, you know. ACBN. I don't know how to say it. I don't know how it'd be right, but I don't think ACBN has feelings. You didn't say it right. ACBN. Anyway, enough of that. Big up to the artisan people of old. Who spoke out. The valiant, the artist. You know? The minstrel. The musical fellow. The singing beauty. The creator of, you know, different types of arts, you know? A lot of religions would get really upset if I said religion is an art. It is. I'm sorry, but the view of it is very... It's like... You know... Imaginative. You know? Well, this is true about certain things happening and us not having a correct understanding of it. Yes, I believe that's so. You know, obviously.